Have you ever coded directly on a robot using Raspberry Pi or NVIDIA Jetson series, setting up new monitor with HDMI, juggling with USB ports for your keyboard and mouse and other sensors, or awkwardly walking between your lab computer with Jetson Nano and come back to your main workstation while your embedded computer compiles the code slowly? There's a better way, actually. In this video, I'll introduce you to NoMachine, a low-latency remote desktop solution that works on almost every device, from embedded computers like Jetson series to smartphones, tablets, and desktops. It's the ultimate way to streamline your robotics workflow. You can connect to all these edge devices from your main workstation. So let's dive in. And if you're new to here, my name is Elliot. I'm a robotics engineer and entrepreneur providing robotics development and training services. So when I first started working with onboard computers for my robots, I used Jetson TK1. It's a compact computer running on Ubuntu 14.04. And to set up, you need a power plug, obviously, and then USBs for your keyboard and mouse, and HDMI cable for a monitor. Essentially, working on this computer requires an extra monitor just for the robot. And initially, it wasn't too bad, but the Jetson TK1 has limited resources and takes like compiling OpenCV for an ARM machine with CUDA support were painfully slow. So I left it while it's compiling, expecting I would come back in like a couple of hours. And then I realized that there was a compilation error, and then I should have started from the beginning. So to avoid this, I was like coming back and forth from my main workstation to my lab, literally walking around here and there while I'm interrupting my own workflow for the main task. So compiling something with this separate computer with a separate monitor was really not a pleasant workflow. So I tried like virtual monitor solutions like Real VNC, Chrome Remote Desktop, but the Real VNC has really high latency, and then Chrome Remote Desktop doesn't even work for these embedded computers like ARM-based Raspberry Pi or Jetson series. And then finally, I discovered this ultimate remote desktop solution. It's called NoMachine. It really works smoothly with embedded computers like Jetson TK1 or Jetson Orin Nano and so on. And it comes with a minimal latency, so I can actually code it in OpenCV and then actually monitor what's going on with the cameras in my lab while I'm working from home. Literally, I can do that. So let me walk through how to download it, how to install it, and how to actually connect between the computers. So to download it, just type NoMachine on Google and then click this link. And then you can download for your Windows, or if you're on Ubuntu system, you can also download Ubuntu for ARM64. Or so if you're on Raspberry Pi, click this guy, Raspberry Pi, or NoMachine for ARM is for Jetson series. And then the most recent Jetson Orin Nano comes with this ARM version 8. Download one of these. Also, NoMachine iOS app and Android app as well. And then just install the installation process. It's pretty straightforward for both Ubuntu, Windows, and Android or iOS all together. So currently I'm on Windows, and then I have installed this NoMachine on my Windows computer. And here's my Windows. I have installed NoMachine. Then on my Jetson, I have also installed NoMachine for ARM version 8. And then literally you will see this. As long as this NoMachine is running on whichever computer, like Jetson or any other Ubuntu, you'll see this icon here because they are all connected within your router, within your LAN. This NoMachine server will be able to detect all the devices under this LAN, which is pretty handy. Now, the connection is pretty straightforward. Just double click it or pop out a new window, and then click OK. So this is my Ubuntu computer sitting down there in my lab. And then if I click Chrome, you can actually work on the Chrome, or you can actually watch YouTube videos using NoMachine. I don't know why, but if you really want, you can do that, which means if you have a camera connected for your robot, it kind of works as an FPV because there's no wired connection with this screen of the NoMachine at your main desktop like this. This is an example of connected NoMachine to the computer on my lab. Then I can increase the size, and then as you can see, the latency is pretty low. I like it. So it kind of works like an FPV if this drone is actually flying around. But of course, I don't recommend it because if you're actually on Jetson Orin Nano series, this screen share communication takes up some RAM space. Also, if you have a tablet, there is a NoMachine app. You can actually connect to Ubuntu, actually not just Ubuntu, but any computer using your tablet as well.
So,
for example, if this Ubuntu computer is running on computer vision or just monitoring what's going on with the webcam, you can actually monitor what's going on in terms of your robot. It's kind of like works like an FPV robot as well. So this NoMachine app is pretty handy. So I have no reason not to recommend it. Also, as I said, the latency is pretty low, so I love it. So that's how I've been using NoMachine to streamline my workflow. It's free software, but if you want to work on multiple devices simultaneously at the same time, there's a paid option too. But honestly, the free version is enough for the most of the use cases for me, connecting to one device at a time, and then I can just keep doing the same thing for the other devices. And it actually made me so much productive because I can just sit on a single desktop while I can work on multiple edge devices. And especially, I don't need to bring any extra keyboard and mouses here and there by myself. So in robotics, we often deal with managing multiple edge devices for extra sensors or coordinating multiple robots, and NoMachine has been a game changer for me. It's hands down the best software I have been using for this kind of work. I can even connect to Jetson Orin Nano while my drone is flying with it. So if you think this is a useful software, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel because it helps YouTube show you more contents like this. And that's it for today. I'm Elliot, I'll see you around.